You are now listening to Femmegard Podcast with Tessa Markle and Carolina Alvarez. Welcome back, listeners. So today we have another guest for you. This is Julia Huffman. I met her because she was one of my teachers in For the Actor with Peter Looney. Fantastic class. Really, if you're an actor that's like in your head, this is a great class just to play and let go of all that. And yeah, I had such a great time in the class and I'm back.
love having you, Tessa.
Thank you.
Aww.
Julia is also a producer, director, writer, and actress. Recently, her film Medicine of the Wolf, which is now on Amazon Prime, correct?
It's on Amazon Prime, Vudu, Hulu, iTunes, and more.
Amazing. And it's getting into festivals and yeah, like it's doing great.
It ran a long festival run and I have a new film out called Wolf Spirit, which is a sequel to Medicine of the Wolf.
Okay.
So that's now in festivals.
Oh, okay. I was getting them confused.
Some people do. Two wolf films. Who knew?
That's awesome. We will ask you a little bit about those. But just to get ourselves started, we have actually Tessa brought the tea today. What is this?
So I love Yogi Brand tea. They have so many awesome different teas. This one is Kava Stress Relief. So it's a mixture of a lot of different herbs. I mean, you have carob, sarsaparilla, cinnamon, ginger. It's really just a nice calming. It's kind of a strong flavor. I can like smell it from here. But it's really good, really earthy, and it's a big stress reliever.
I feel more at ease right now.
I have to say, I just got out of LA traffic, as you ladies know. And this is great. This is perfect. So thank you. Good choice, Tessa.
Fantastic.
This is awesome. Yes.
Yogi tea saving the day again.
Saving the day.
I know.
All right. Should we get into our game?
Yes. Yes, we shall. So we always like to do a little icebreaker game, a little tomfoolery with our tea. And so essentially, you have phrases, and then you're going to choose an accent card. Now, it might not just be an accent. It might be more than that.
A character or an emotion or some way to express your saying.
She does it a little
dance. Shaking it up, ladies. Are you trying to get me out of my head? Is that what's happening here?
Yeah, now Tessa is going to turn this around.
Yep. It was planned. Love it.
Yeah.
So what do I do?
So, you're going to choose an accent card. At the same time, you're going to pick up your phrase card and you're going to say the phrase with whatever accent or thing you get.
And we'll try to guess it.
We'll try to guess it. So you'll go ahead first.
Okay, choosing the card. Since we don't have video, I'll share it.
Oh, no, you don't share it. You don't share the accent.
Yeah, because we'll guess it.
You'll have to guess it. Sorry.
You'll know why I'm laughing in a minute. Okay.
Amazing.
Okay, here we
Amazing.
Go. So I'm going to be telling you this with this accent.
Uh-huh.
All right. Let me put my voice to the side of the microphone and do this. I think that it's sad how parallel lines never touch.
Okay.
Let's see. So it's she's yelling, but I feel like there's more than that, too.
It's like... she's like announcer. No.
Long distance.
This describes what I did.
Okay.
This card you gave me is describing what I did. FYI. Not necessarily an accent, but it's describing what I did.
Yelling, shouting. Shouting.
Bingo!
Oh, okay.
Yay!
Like, it can't be that simple.
I know. That's why I had to laugh. Because I'm like, I'm going to blast these women out before we even get going.
Right? Okay, I'll hold
she
the deck
did it
for
with
you.
Such conviction.
Oh, all trust right. me, I can.
All right, please. Okay. I knew I made it once Kathy Griffin chopped my head off. Yeah.
First of all, I like that saying.
Interesting.
Yeah, dude, totally.
Oh, yeah.
I totally made it when Kathy Griffin chopped my head off.
You're California talking.
Like a stoner?
Yeah.
Oh, stoner. Like a stoner.
California stoner. Stoner. Got it.
Stoner.
Nice. Good job.
All right. So I'm just going to pick the top one here. Okay.
I wish cheese was good for you. Elon, please get on that. Ha ha
ha. Oui, oui, mon chéri. La française.
Oui, oui.
French. Nice job.
Very
Tessa.
Nice. Tessa, very
that
nice.
Was like a Peter Sellers kind of French. Remember
yeah.
him?
Yeah.
Oui, oui, mon chéri.
I love it. All right. You have one more.
Okay. Oh, my God. Oh, this is, oops, hilarious. I have to check myself so I don't, like, cough. Okay. Let me remember how this person does this. Okay, I am strong. Most babies are too stupid to know that they're wearing hand-me-down clothes.
Very nice. Arnold Schwarzenegger.
Oh, nice.
Very nice. I was like, immediately, I was like, she got it. She committed.
Thank God. Because I was like, do I even know how to do Arnold? How does somebody do Arnold?
Yeah.
See where Terminator. Commitment gets you, folks?
All right, okay. Right. My turn. Okay. Oh my God. Okay. Jason Momoa is the kind of dirty I can get behind.
Redneck?
No, it didn't need to come out. Jason Momoa is.
Oh, we jive talking. No?
No. It's kind of dirty.
Oh, an old lady. Granny? Are you granny?
Kind of man. you were close, but I'm trying to, like, fix my, not kind of lady, but kind of man.
Grandpa? Grandpa?
Old man? Grumpy old man.
Oh, okay.
I was trying to add a little hump. You were like, I don't know how to.
You were like crotchety crampy. Yeah.
Yeah.
Were you grandpa?
Okay. Old man.
There you go.
Bingo. Channeled grandpa, though.
Yeah, that was a hard one. Yeah. Good job.
Because I had to get the grumpiness.
Yeah, it's like grumpy and old.
Yeah.
And get that man voice in there. Okay. The sound effect is going to help with this one because I don't really know how to. Don't make me step outside my safe space and hurt you.
Oh my gosh. Wow. That
I know
was good.
It.
Sound
I know
effect.
It.
You know it?
Yeah.
Oh, say it. By all means.
Just because I was like, this card slipped out last night and I was like, I don't know how. Just because when she did this, I was like, I have no idea how I would do this.
Yeah.
But I don't think he talks. So I don't, I can only go by the sound. It's Chewbacca.
Holy moly.
Right? Like, he doesn't say actual words, does
right.
he?
Yeah, that was a good sound effect, though. I was like, video game, Chewbacca. Nice.
I was like, this really makes my Chewbacca. That's my Chewbacca.
Are you sure we shouldn't be drinking with this game?
I know, right? That might have to be our new thing. You're like the third guest that said that.
You're the third guest. I mean, I'm kind of kidding, because I don't drink anymore.
Only
but
kind.
I do love tea, but, you know, it does make you think that, yeah.
Maybe it would like, what's that? Yeah. Is there like Irish coffee? Is there like a tea that's right. spiked? Like a Russian, a hot toddy.
Hot toddy.
Hot toddy.
Hot toddy.
I don't know why Russian came up. But. I don't know. I just
White
like,
Russian?
I knew some Russians. They might, oh yeah. They might, like they...
Now we're going somewhere. Is this politics or entertainment?
I'm half Polish, right? So, okay. you know, I, you know. Eastern you can't help European to go there. Friends. I can't help it. Yeah. I can't help it.
Perfect.
We love a tea.
We'll get into business a little bit here.
Yeah. Yeah.
So basically, we want to talk to you, Julia, about just making a film. Like, what led you to go in the direction you did with genre? You know, how did you choose? Did you want to be director, writer, like all of those things? Did that just kind of happen? How did you get started with your films?
Okay. I mean, yeah, there's a long lineage, but I'll try to cut it down short because I know, you know, we want to talk about lots of things. But I always wanted to be a filmmaker, and I worked on a film called Wrestling with God in college, and I was an intern, and I just fell in love with collaborative storytelling. And, you know, the man that was the director, Jerry Jackson, was just a great leader. And he had a beautiful story that he had carried for many years. So I fell in love with the collaborative storytelling. Mm-hmm. I fell in love with, you know, just carrying your passion the way that he did and caring for the story. And I learned a lot from watching him work with actors and his crew, and everybody was very included. Mm-hmm. And so, I've come from a background of sports. And so for me, the appeal of a collaborative thing, mm-hmm. a team thing, really was appealing to me. Mm-hmm. I studied broadcast journalism in college. I got a degree in broadcast journalism. But then I started going, you know what? I'm not so sure if I mm-hmm. want to do the reporter thing. I'm not so sure if that's really... I worked at a news station for a while. Fast forward to, I said, you know what? I'm going to pursue this filmmaking storytelling thing. So I moved to Los Angeles, and I, you know, there's just a lot of things that I went through on that journey to finally coming back to, you know what, I want to tell stories. You know, mm-hmm. I worked in entertainment for a while as a production assistant. I worked at 20th Century Fox Lot as a post-production coordinator. So, you know, I was immersing myself in the storytelling world, filmmaking and television production. I worked as a TV producer for a while and did HGTV shows.
Girl.
So
done it all.
I've been in LA for a little while now, ladies.
But she's like super hot, guys. Like you can't even you'll see. You'll see.
Bless you. Yeah. Came here to get a little boost in my ego. Bless you. And you ladies are beautiful too. So aww, hey, yeah, yes.
Thank you.
But here we are. And anyway, so I always was holding that storytelling thing. Mm-hmm. And so I eventually went out and started working on my own project, mm-hmm. which I know you two ladies are doing and have done, which mm-hmm. I commend you for doing that because,
thank you.
You know, you asked, how did I get into it, right? So there's all the kind of backstory stuff mm-hmm. about my journey. But I always held that piece that I wanted to tell stories, and I really wanted to tell stories about women. I wanted to tell things that move me personally, mm-hmm. right? And
right.
so that's my thing. You know, like
absolutely.
I want to tell stories about things that matter to me.
Yeah, absolutely.
And so, right?
I'm sure a bunch of our listeners could definitely agree, understand if they're mm-hmm. starting out. That's what propelled us too. We're tired of these casting breakdowns. Like none of that
speaks to us. Yeah.
Speaks to us. Exactly. And then you coming also from, I mean, an acting background, we are storytellers. So mm-hmm. it just, that's kind of, you know, propelled us to, okay, how do we shape our own voices in this industry?
Yeah. You brought up a really good point, which I think about a lot these days. And I think mm-hmm. a lot of artists are, and particularly women are, just how can we shape our own narratives? Mm-hmm. What stories are important to tell? You know, and really being the carriers of those stories, right? Because
right.
as women, we're nurturers. You know, we have different things to bring to the table mm-hmm. that are unique.
Right.
Right.
Absolutely.
We do. And so I'm really about celebrating that,
yeah,
right?
Yeah.
As women, as artists. Mm-hmm. And, you know, not just women, but, you know,
absolutely.
I'm really about celebrating women right now. And, you know, the work that I continue to do is in mind of women and strength and power and how important our voices are and what unique abilities we have as storytellers. But just to go back for a minute, so I worked on my own project.
Uh-huh.
I went out and shot and learned how to edit and went on this crazy adventure to tell a story back in West Virginia, where I'm from.
Uh-huh.
And I worked on it for years. And I went crazy as an artist, as we do. Yeah, you know, I mean, it's a lot to take on when you're first, you know, getting your feet wet because, you know, to learn to edit, to learn to shoot, to learn to narrate and to learn to write, you know, I've, you know, I had some training in it, but when when you're doing it and you care about it so much, there's a lot of pressure. Uh-huh. But, you know, I just kind of forged ahead and I made this short film about this double murder back in my hometown that I cared about very much. And eventually I hired editors and I hired camera people and my work started, it felt like my work started growing and getting better and getting better and getting better. But it, I always say this, it was through a lot of learning and a lot of mistakes and a lot of, you know, just, you know, wanting to throw my computer out the window and, you know, crying in the corner and, you know, just all these things that we go through as artists to carry those stories. But eventually I started learning and it was really my film school, that process. And so when I finally eventually did Medicine the Wolf, was which was my first documentary feature that, you know, got out in the world and, you know, Dr. Jane Goodall endorsed it and, you know, some dreams
came. Which is amazing.
Yeah. My hero.
Yeah.
You know, she's been my hero since I was a child. You know, so I thought, wow, okay. So someone's listening, right? Because you hope that someone cares and someone's listening and you get an audience, right? But I know that all that work that I did with the short film, which, you know, I'm still with that project, by the way. I haven't left it. I'm still with it, trying to carry that forward in many ways. But I really cut my teeth on working on that film about the two women. And decided that, you know what, I am a director. I can do this.
Yeah.
You know?
Isn't that an amazing, like... You have this mental block almost for a while. You're like, nah, I don't know. And then it's just like, who's you? It's just you saying to yourself.
Nobody's stopping you.
No one's stopping you. But it's like it's a cheesy old saying, but it's so true. Even when the short films we did, I'm like, am I going to really direct it? But I want to, but I don't know if I can, but I want to. And it's like, just be the director.
Just so
do it. Yeah.
It's so true. And it sounds so cliche sometimes, but, you know, I would just say to people who are listening, you know, if you're with a project or want to go back to a project or whatever it is, you know, I suffer from being a perfectionist as well. You know, so I get to work on that in my art and like try to have compassion for myself when I get into needing everything to be perfect in the midst of needing to learn.
Yeah.
And giving myself permission just to learn and go through the learning curves. You know, if I could go back to my young self, I'd say, give yourself a little bit of break, honey. You know, quit being so damn serious. You know, yes, it's serious, but like, just loosen up a little and know that you're going to experience the learning curve and you're going to second guess. And, you know, what you finish might not be exactly what you want it to be. But, you know, I hear artists who have things at Sundance or, you know, award-winning directors who weren't quite happy with everything or actors in their performances. And I think we have to give ourselves permission for it not to be perfect, for us to make mistakes, but just to walk through it and learn as much as you can, right?
Right.
And then hopefully move on to the next thing, right? And then you're going to learn some more. I mean, I'm in the stage of negotiating contracts and, you know, I went through this whole thing with distribution of my film and, you know, all this stuff that as an artist, I was like, I don't want to do that.
Yeah.
But, you know, sometimes you have to.
Yeah.
And so it was a huge, those things were huge learning curves for me. Right. So there's all these steps we get to go through. Oh, right.
Absolutely. Because it sounds like the business side, all of that. And that's something we're creatives. It's like, OK, where's the business brain that we've been building and learning about? And yeah, sometimes it's not exactly what we were planning or wanting ideally to do. But
you learn on the job, like you were saying, you know, like you learn to edit while you're making your film. So you know, it's all stuff that you learn by necessity.
Which is really cool to hear. Which is really cool to hear. Because sometimes we're like, are we the only ones doing it like this? Like, is this okay?
I completely understand. And I think we need each other as artists. I think we need, like, I think that is, you know, just doing this with you ladies and supporting you, that I'm honored to be here.
Yeah.
And support your journey.
Yeah.
And, you know, I try to extend myself to other artists. And, you know, as I've been negotiating some of my contracts and going through this other learning curve, I've had women show up for me in these beautiful ways that have been there. You know what I mean? And I think that if we can keep doing that for each other.
Oh, absolutely.
Right? We create this kind of circle of golden circle of help and that we can help each other kind of move on to those O steps. Because it's impossible to try to do it alone.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, absolutely.
And we shouldn't have to.
Right.
No.
You know? We shouldn't have to do it alone.
Yeah. Oh, I think that there's that movement. It's kind of starting even more so nowadays. And I'm just so glad that the women we have reached out to you, like you, have shown up for us, like, yeah, on this podcast, or to answer questions on distribution. Like, we have no idea. And and we just need someone to be real with us, too, at the end of the day. Mm-hmm.
Thank you. Right?
Yeah.
We do need that. We need real, because there's a lot of smoke and mirrors in that world. Trust me. I've been walking through it.
Yeah.
I won't talk about it on this podcast.
Well, maybe a future episode. But
let
in
me
the
know.
Meantime, speaking of support, is there, do you have a website, or what's the best way for people to keep track of what you're doing, see your work, all that kind of stuff?
Oh, thank you so much for asking. Well, I'm really in the process of building a website, and I'm building a website called, I believe it's the name, I'm still working with the name, but it's something like Filmmaker Coach.
Okay. Okay.
And, you know, I coach actors, Tessa, and I coach people for public speaking. I did a TEDx, and, you know, people come to me for a lot of advice on filmmaking. And so I'm putting something together like a filmmaking coach website where people can come to me for these different things.
Yeah.
And I've done it for a couple of years for free, because, and I, you know, I still would do it, you know, to help people, because, like I said, people have helped me. But, you know, I'm turning it into a business model, and, you know, hope to continue doing this for people on that level, you know, whether it's being an advisor on their film, executive producer type of thing, or coming in and giving people notes, or even coaching them on, you know, the distribution world.
That's amazing.
Those are the things that I'm going to avail myself to doing, and hope to support other artists getting their work out there.
That's great. Yeah.
So when you get that together, please send it to us, and we'll do a little later on shout out. Whenever you have it ready, we'll just, you know, remind everyone we had you on the show, and this is what you're up to, because that's huge. That's something we could benefit
from.
Who's an independent filmmaker or not, you know, that's huge.
And if you are an actor and looking for a good class, Julia teaches with Peter at For the Actor. You can find him on Facebook, and you might see me in class sometimes. So,
Tessa drops in, and we love having you, Tessa. And you're a wonderful actress.
Thank you.
And lovely creative. Both of you are so creative, and I loved your work. So, congratulations moving forward, right?
Yeah. Yes.
Congratulations. Oh, and our website is filmactingteacher.com. So,
perfect.
Just so everybody knows if they want to come find us.
Awesome. Well, thank you guys for listening, and thank you, Julia, for being here, and we will see you next time.
Thanks for listening to Femme Regard Podcast. If you like what you hear, tune in next time for more tips on the filmmaking business and insightful conversations with industry professionals over tea.
We can only grow with your support, so please subscribe, share, rate, and give us a 5-star review on Apple Podcast. If you leave us a great comment, we might give you a shout out on the show. For more on us, check us out at femregard.com.